I love jiu-jitsu, you know. I love it being around people. I love being training. I love being competing, but competing I cannot do for that long. So I would like to make the transition now, you know. When I'm young, I can enjoy teaching also, you know, helping people. So it's been good.
Was that initially kind of difficult for you? Because even for me, like, being at this tournament, I'm missing it. I wish I was competing today. I wish I could compete more often, but sometimes just traveling is tough and everything like that. And I know you and your brother are very, like, you know, very avid competitors. Was it kind of difficult at first? Or I remember you telling me, I asked, like, oh, did you miss it? And you didn't really seem like you missed it too much.
Yeah, no, I'll be honest, I don't miss it because I feel like I did good in competing, you know? I did, for me it was enough. Maybe for other people it's not enough, but for me it was enough. I won some titles, I lost some also, but for me it was a good journey competing, good journey of learning, you know? So I honestly don't miss it. I like to be around, but I don't miss being inside of the mat and competing. I enjoy being like outside, watching my friends, helping them, you know?
Yeah. You like seeing people be able to accomplish their goals
as well.
Yeah, was there like a certain time when you realized, or do you said it was just mainly your knee that kind of changed that? Did you always enjoy teaching, or was it something that you kind of had to...
Man, before something... I hate teaching, man. I don't know if I'm not... I think it was more because I'm not comfortable speaking English also. Okay. Because I'm in the United States like, for 5 years and I'm not like... I don't know, I don't feel comfortable speaking English, you know, it's like, it's another language, I don't know if the people gonna make fun of me, but when you realize that people doesn't care how you speak, doesn't care anything, then you become more like open to try new things, you know, and it was this time that I start teaching.
I think people like the accent too, like when you say nice, when you add the nicey to the end. When
like Carly, right? Carly.
I love when you say
nicey.
She counts the amount of niceys that she gets in a practice. She's like, I got 3 niceys today. Yeah, so at the end of the day, you realize when you put yourself out there more that people appreciate the effort that you put into the practice and like, show how much you care. It's not going to matter how perfect the English is at that point.
Yeah, I think so too. Because honestly, what matters is like you showing. Jiu-jitsu is more like this. Something, of course, you have to speak something, and these things I think I'm able to speak. But the most thing you can learn is just watching, you know? I'm honestly learning a lot just watching people like fighting, competing, you know? So if you have this in mind, you can learn everything, you know?
Yeah. One thing I'm very impressed with your practices is that... You do a very good job of teaching a very well-rounded game. It's very easy for someone like your style with like barambolos and your style of passing to just show kind of what you're best at, but I feel like you do a very good job at showing everything, like you're going over-unders, maybe if it's not all your game, or you taught single leg X, and a lot of stuff that I've learned from Marcelo, you know. How you were able to kind of like be able to explain all these different positions?
Yeah, probably the single X I learned from Marcelo also. Yeah. Just watching, you know? No, like.
But it's very well detailed, too. It's not just like, yeah, this is what I know here, but you know the details very well.
Yes, I really, like I say to you, I really like watching people fighting. I really like you watch people instructionals, you know? And I'm always like, we need to learn something new, you know?
Yeah.
And I think the most important thing when you learn something, you try this thing, right? And I'm always trying to do, like, even if, like, I'm sparring with anyone, but I'm trying to do, like, the things that I want to learn. Some people learn something and they say, no, they fail in the first time and then, no, this don't work for me, I'm gonna stick for the thing that I'm good. But I know I try, I see the variations that, like, fit for me and just keep learning more and more.
Yeah, I noticed a big difference. It's been really fun being with you and your brother the last like almost a year now, because so many people like think you guys are very much the same, but I now see you guys as very different. I can tell who it is, you know. I can tell the difference. There's a huge difference between when we roll. Like your brother's always trying to kill me. I'm like, dude, it's Saturday. Come on, chill. But you, I feel like you have a lot of like technical goals
Yeah.
I noticed, I can tell when you're working on certain things.
I wanna, you know, some people teach something like things that I'm not like. Maybe we can cut if you want.
No, no. We can. We can work around it.
Maybe people like teach something that doesn't work, you know. And I wanna, like, I feel bad if I teach something like that doesn't work. So I mean, go there in the sparring, try to do the thing that I'm teaching, you know.
Yeah.
Because I think it's not honest for my students. There, I teach something that is like, even for me, is working, you know. Some people can teach something that's work for them, it's then don't work for them, it's fine, you know. But at least I'm trying to put like the things that I'm teaching when I'm sparring also, you know.
I see that, because you're applying all the techniques that you're working on me, and then you're teaching the class. Actually, most of the time I can tell what you're going to work on in the classes based on how our rounds go. Do you feel like almost teaching is probably, I feel like teaching almost can make you better as well. I'm impressed with your game more now than I was when we competed, because I feel like it's incredibly well-rounded. Because you're trying to apply things like you put me in single airs the first time and I'm like, oh, this isn't really his game, but it felt very strong, and also I noticed you were teaching it a good amount. Uh-huh. So I guess maybe I'm answering for you, but would you agree that you feel like maybe your game is in some ways kind of improved with
teaching more? Yes. First, thank you for the compliments, you know. But yes, I think when I'm teaching, I'm learning also, you know. I mean, just not teaching for you guys, for like for the my the people that are they're like there for learn from me, but I'm teaching myself also when I'm there in the middle of the class teaching, you know, because I start like figure out things that I even like know if I'm not teaching, I explain for other people, you know, and I can make sure that every detail is there, you know.
But what are like some of the challenges that you feel that like, say if you like you're new in the game as a teacher, what are some things that, and you seem like a perfectionist to me, what are some things that you feel like you want to get better at, or what are some of the things that you find challenging in teaching?
I think my English, I want to get better my English first.
I feel
thing.
Like my English can always get better too,
I want to get better my English. I mean planning my class and everything, but I want to get better in this part also.
Yeah. I like your curriculum, but I think the way you do it works very well, because
you.
I find myself remembering, I'm sorry I'm cutting you off,
nope.
But I find myself remembering a lot of things that you teach because you spend a good amount of time on it, which I think is very important.
Yes.
Yeah.
I think this is important, you know, you don't keep switching like every week something, keep like at least like 2 weeks, 3 weeks teaching like the same thing, because then the people can have time to review, have time to try in class, and then have time to come back and ask you why it's not working, why, when the guy do that, do this, you know?
Yeah.
So I think it's really important, it takes some time.
Do you look forward to having a lot of students someday? Because the one thing I always fear is me is like, it's easy to kind of control a smaller group. But then when you start having a bigger group someday, that's the real challenge in teaching, I feel.
Yes, it's true. Yes, this is a good point. I didn't think of this. Yes, I think...
Sorry, I kind of had that in my mind.
Yes, I think it's a good point, you know, like in a small group is easy like to be like around everybody, you know, but when you're the group start grow, so people can get jealous about you, don't have more your attention, like when it was small, you know, it's just challenging. But you know, you just have to live this to learn. So if you don't live it, you cannot learn it.
And would you have any suggestions maybe to like students who maybe are in big classes but you know are kind of seeking attention? Would you suggest anything to like show like an instructor like hey or approach an instructor? What would you suggest so that people can make sure that they get the help that they feel like they need?
I think this is a it's the part of the job of the professor also, and he make the people feel welcome, feel like they are important also, you know, like probably if you have more classes, have less people in each class, and the professor can give more attention, or you even can go there and talk with professor, you know, say, man, I need more attention, I want to improve, but I feel you're not giving me that much attention that I need, you know, and see what happens, you know, if your professor still doesn't care, what you can do,
yeah.
move forward, you know, move forward.
Yeah, that's it. Man, I don't know, this is fun. I can keep doing this, but I don't want to keep too much of your time. No, thank you for doing this.
Thank you so much, man. Thank you.
Let's get back to New York soon and get back to training.
Yes, of course. Let's do it. Thank you, guys.